All right, here at Ravixel, this is our third game of this night's games. So, we're here now, December 9th, 2017, 3.2 patch. And, just coming off an Axis victory. So game one, Allied victory. Game two, Axis victory. And here we have Chris as Germany, Waff as Italy, Exo. Oh, Exo's on. He's a new addition to this nice game. Spain, Della as UK, Pelican as France, Brontoker as Norway, and Argonaut now taking his turn at Russia. So Delacroix has been Russia the last two games, so now he's hopped over to UK. A little quick, fast six tank. So the goal of the six tank is to knock out as much as you can, and he knocked out this one barrack, bunker. Wasn't really able to knock out too much else. And see what he's going to be doing, sending up the turkey men. I'll look quickly on the supply depot. Arg at the max. Probably gonna wait for his next land lease. So does he wait for his next trigger, or is he gonna go? No, he's gonna go. Chris getting some nice damage done before his move come in. There's Reich joining that Death in Europe game. Go get him, buddy. Show 1939 proud. Very solid attack. Spain is up and being able to show up, but here Pelican moving around once again on Exo. Exo hasn't been around too much recently, so he doesn't really know the shenanigans that Pelican puts, and he's really going hard tonight. Being able to get the starport. Not quite the CC. Once again, he does not go for the control tower. I'd like to maybe ask him directly why he doesn't go for that. So maybe he'll tell me after watching one of these videos. But getting a 47 kill hold, so better than the last time I saw him do that. He was rocking around 33, so getting half decent hold. Exo, he's one of the only guys I see do this. I do it very, very rarely, but Exo does it more regularly. This is the, I think it's three drops. No, he does two drops. You can also do three if you want, but two works as well. And you send the scouts up there as well. The scouts were not in France to help out, so that's the disadvantage. The advantage is you knock out this precious starport, and you knock out USA, which forces Norway's drop to almost certainly be here in USA, but maybe do a little shenanigans here in France. The conservative play would be to drop USA. The aggressive play would be to drop either Belgium, France, or drop right here, right now, or some type of thing. We'll get an off for that. Let's see how this works out. Already a good flank here by Italy. Getting down a really solid amount of men. It's going to make a difference. It's going to make a big difference. Let's see how this plays out. Axis have run out of ground, except for the tanks down below, but the tanks don't shoot up, so not giving any support to the raft that are about shooting them. Scouts here from Spain coming just in the nick of time, but real solid attack and great decision there by Krontoker on that drop, guaranteeing getting the core, and was able to get enough men down so that most of the BCs were down, so three of them left. Looks like he's gonna go, I thought he was gonna yam that. Exo starting to rebuild. Tell me he's building three barracks. No, two barracks and an airport. Very cool. going down to this area. Probably actually just gonna lift it up. We already have an attachment. No use building another one. Pull extra tanks. Now personally, me, I like as access, either as Germany or Italy, to take out the ground around this area. Because you have these cities here, and they become more fluid. If you don't have all these pesky bunkers and buildings here, it means you can kind of jump in, knock out a couple of city tacks, and jump out, or even go and steal it with an SCV. Oh, there we have Kron calling out his drop, just a little bit too late on it. You want to get there about 30 seconds before, so you can knock out some of the tacks before two. But they're still able to get the BC. That's 1500. Going over in favor of the allies. Just that's in unit cost, I mean. So keep going, attacking Kron. Don't want to go against the BCs. There he goes. Della's calling the wall. And now that he's put the renewed focus on there, he should be able to knock out all the Marines. Really should be on that. And a very successful drop. Kron doing showing it up on Norway's, and I've really seen Norway's picking up their game in ever since we've came back since our 4-year hiatus. Norway's are being quite pivotal for games, occasionally, not all the time. Just I'm noticing it more. Little early bunker wall by Chris. Now, the reason you don't do it here is because you can only put three, and it's not enough to dissuade, like if tanks set up, it's hard for you to send men through those bunkers unless you have BCs down. It is good because you can get a real forward position and you can lock up the city, so you can keep getting attacks for it, but that's the disadvantage of having it. Advantage is, yeah, you get the attacks, you can stack BCs there. The allies can't even put that many men along this narrow portion, so it's easier to come Messer if they do start attacking. So some positives, some negatives. Exo getting the med trig, no sweat. Very unusually that the USA has not been recaptured. That's because Kron went aggressive and he got the AWOL for it, so hey, that was worth it. Better to get the AWOL out, guaranteed, than to go for the USA and possibly have it redropped in the next turn or two. Then you gotta put another drop together. So Exo putting good attention on Africa, so last couple games, this is what we've seen. Spain's going, taking turns going either up to UK, USA, and then back to Africa, going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, letting France go ahead and take it, and then putting a drop together and retaking it, often coordinating with Axis Air, and that's a real key to winning this, as Axis is having your ground and air coordinate with one another, especially in Africa. Nice having the two BCs. You don't often see the two BCs come down and try to make a difference, but they're making quite the difference in Zulov's attack. That might not be enough, because he's got too many buildings, not being able to get enough troops down in this area before reinforcements come. Della may like a dive. The wrong thing. Oh wow, if he wish he saw that. He doesn't see him, that's why. If he saw them. At least two dead there. Very logically, going ahead and taking to Canada. Troops are not even loaded. You should notice that. You should start attacking right now. If you see that they're not loaded, that means you know that they're not in here. There's Norway coming. having a little bit of a tussle. Bunking up, there's the fourth bunk. Possibly gonna build a fifth one as well. He's got some money for it. Has been collecting his USA attacks for the last two turns. Nice to have that. But can't count on that any further. So he's gonna spend a lot of money on this defense there, but retains the pivotal Algiers area. So yes, they don't have UK. Yes, he just lost USA, but nice solid hole on Algiers, so still good money coming in for Nexo. Right now with Arg seeing this, he, especially with seeing Spain there, kinda don't want to be going this anymore. Look how far back these bunkers are. That is the farthest bunker wall back I've seen in, I think, years. I think years. I think many, many, I don't even remember the last time. Have to combine with all the Marines, even on board. There they go. Yeah, that was a really nice play. Coordination by Chris and Exo. Stop that attack for now. Khan is just reloading, healing up. Lots of tanks, including these Spanish tanks. Exo says, you know what, the best place for my tanks is on east. We'll go tank for tank. Wanna stop the Balt attacks with tanks? You see the massive tide of men that must have came through here, wiped everything out like a glacier. Just digging up lakes, leaving no nothing behind. Look at this. BCs. Defensive drop by Spain. Probably can't get too far with this. Probably wouldn't stop because France is just gonna back up to here and turn on you. Alright, keep constant pressure. Walk going back for it. tanks. Looks like it came back. Spain sent his tanks back. Curious to see where the next attack's gonna be. Here the Italian air is coming. Support air getting damaged. Looks like Peloton got that attack. Strangely, the BCs are not clearing out this ground. You just stand up the coast here and fire down that ground. You can't be attacked either, so. Would have kept that down there. Because maybe fearing a Russian attack. Probably sensing that. They're getting flanked. XO bringing his tanks back here was just enough to be able to hold this. Without these six tanks, this goes very different. So great decision making by XO. We don't see him on very often, but hey, he still's got that mind of the game. Popular Athens bunker will not be allowed to be completed. So Axis know that the Wrath is in Africa. So knowing that, he's gonna be able to take Ireland. Probably gonna hit this armory. Oh, he was just there. He was just there, Chris. London tax. Didn't help the cause, that's for sure. But with Pelican going east, it's pretty much this east attack or it's finished. Really not much else that's gonna go on. The Allies could play it where they try to take Algiers, they try to take Turkey, they keep dropping UK just so that the Axis can't control it. They make sure to control USA and Canada. And then they just keep dropping, keep dropping, keep dropping, keep taking tax, keep killing buildings, and play out a long game, but doesn't look like that's gonna happen. They saw them. Axis is positioned down low. And they have the bunkers protecting the area. So what you really want is you want to wait for the allies are right here when you're the Axis. And then you want to go and attack. You want these to be repairing, doing damage, while you're pushing upwards. That way you get that full flank. Allies are certainly going to go east. No way they're going to go below because they have too much. See if anybody calls to attack south. Because really, if the Allies knew exactly how the map was set up, they'd want to take all of this, move it right around here, and then go directly down. Press down. Not even touch this, just go down. So let's see how this works out. There's Kron calling it. Let's see. Do they respond? Right now, all of these men need to just go boom. Jam all this. Jam all this with men. Tanks right around here. Excellent. First gun dropping right underneath the PCs. That's gonna tear apart the Wrath. Wrath can't be taking minion fire. I'm trying to get some hot shots to the PC. They can be successful. He didn't take out most of the messers. Messers looking for PCs to kill. Only one more left. He already done a good job. Axis, about 4 or 5 PCs left. They're starting to fall. Ground advantage for the Allies. It looks like they're going to be able to take this one big attack from the Allies. Being able to turn this game. Well, maybe not completely turn it, because the Axis didn't have that much air, but seeing what they had to do. Good call out by Kron Toker, calling the low when he saw it, and with that big army, that good call, won the game.